Hello, Class 8 students. Welcome back to the Civics class. I am your Social Science Digital Mentor, and today we are going to start Chapter 4, The Union Executive. Learning Objectives. Meaning of Executive, the President of India, the Prime Minister and Council of Ministers, Parliamentary System, the Vice President, Civil Services, Servants. Let's warm up. Look at the following pictures. Identify the famous personality pictured alongside, what role do they play in the making of laws? Application skills. The children of class 8B were shocked to see a girl who had fainted in the school playground. They immediately called Miss Shikha for help. She took the child to the school doctor. When she returned to the class, Miss Shikha said that the girl was a construction worker opposite the school and she had fainted when she came looking for some water in the school. She also said that there are many young children who work for a living, as their parents cannot afford to send them to school. In April 2009, a landmark law was added to ensure that education became a fundamental right of the children. She said that the students would learn more about that in the class. Why do poor find it difficult to get an education? Why is it important to provide education to the poor? Meaning of executive. Executive is that organ of government which enforces the laws made by the legislature and runs the administration of the country. The union executive consists of the president, the vice president, the prime minister and his council of ministers. Parliamentary system. The constitution sets up parliamentary government both at the center and in the states. Under parliamentary system, there exists a clear distinction between nominal executive and the real executive. The nominal executive is the president, who is the head of the state. The real executive is the council of ministers, headed by the prime minister. The council of ministers is collectively responsible to the Lok Sabha. Ministerial responsibility is the essential features of a parliamentary democracy. In this picture, you can see Draupadi Murmu, President of India, Srimati Pratibha Patil, the first woman President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the first scientist to be elected as the President. The President of India. The President is the head of the state and the first citizen of the country. The Constitution confers extensive powers on the President. Qualifications. In order to be elected president, a candidate must have the same qualification as the member of the Lok Sabha. However, he she must be at least 35 years of age. Election. The president is elected by an electoral college consisting of the elected members of the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the Vidhan Sabhas of the states. Terms of office. The president of India is normally elected for 5 years. His term of office can in no case be extended. His office may fall vacant under the following conditions. Number 1. Death. In the case of the death of the president, his office falls vacant. The president, the vice president immediately takes over as the president. Election for a new president must be held within 6 months of the date on which the vice president takes over as the acting president. Resignation. The president may resign from his post at any time. The vacancy in this case is also filled in, as is done in the case of the death of the president. Number 3. Impeachment. The president can be impeached only for violation of the constitution. The impeachment process can be started by either of the two houses of the parliament. Specific charges have to be brought against him by 2/3 majority of the house. Then the other house investigates the charges. If the investigating house also passes a resolution by the 2/3 of majority sustaining the charges, the president is removed from his post. Pay and allowances. The president of the Indian Republic gets a monthly pay of ₹1,50,000 per month. Besides, he gets such facilities and allowances as may be decided by the parliament from time to time. Powers of the president. The president possesses wide administrative, military, diplomatic, legislative, financial, judicial and emergency powers. Administrative powers. The president has the power to appoint the prime minister, but the election is restricted to the leader of the party in majority in the house of the people or a person who is in position to win the confidence of the majority. He also appoints other ministers on the advice of the Prime Minister. Ministers have to inform the President about all important decisions they make. All top-level officials of the Union Government are appointed by the President and can be removed by him. He appoints the judges of the Supreme Court and High Court. He also controls the administration of the Union Territories directly. Military powers. He is the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces in the country. He can declare war or conclude peace. Diplomatic powers. The President of India represents India in international forums and sends and receives ambassadors. All the international treaties and agreements are concluded in his names. Legislative powers. A bill passed by both the houses of the parliament goes to the President for his approval and signatures in token of his assent. The President may, if he is not satisfied, sends back the bill after making his suggestions to the Parliament. However, it is for the Parliament to accept the suggestions and modify the bill or just pass it. When it goes to the President for the second time, it is obligatory on the part of the President to give his assent. The Parliament meets on being summoned by the President on the advice of the Prime Minister. The President can dissolve the Parliament. If the Parliament is not in session and need arises, the President can, on his own, make laws which become effective immediately. Such laws are called ordinances. Fact file. An ordinance has a maximum life period of 6 months. Financial powers. Our President has given vast financial powers also. He causes the annual budget and the supplementary budget to be laid before the Parliament. No money bill can be introduced in the Parliament without his prior assent. He can sanction money from the contingency fund. In this image, you can see V.V. Giri became the Vice President of India in 1967. He was elected as new President of India in 1969 upon the death of President Dr. Zakir Hussain. In this image, you can see Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, the second President of India, 1962-67. Judicial powers. The President has given a number of powers in the judicial sphere also. He is not answerable before any court of law for the discharge of his duties. He has the power to grant pardons, to remit or suspend a sentence of punishment on any appeal for mercy. He can commute even death sentence to imprisonment for life or otherwise. Emergency powers. The President also have important emergency powers to deal with any kind of abnormal situations. If the security of India is threatened by a war or armed rebellion, the President can declare a state of emergency for the whole of India or for any of its parts. Secondly, if the governance of a state cannot be carried on in accordance with the provisions of the Constitution, the President can take over the entire work of the executive and suspend the state assembly. This is called the President's rule in the states. Thirdly, if the President thinks that the financial stability of a country is threatened, he, she can declare a financial emergency. The President is only a constitutional head and exercises his power on the advice of the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers. Fact file. National emergency was declared for the first time in 1962 when China attacked India. The Vice President. The Constitution also provides for a Vice President for the Republic of India. He is also the Chairman of the Rajya Sabha. In this image, you can see Jagdeep Dhankar. Qualifications. A candidate to the office of the Vice President of India must possess the same qualifications as are essential for the office of the President. Moreover, he should be qualified to be elected to the Rajya Sabha or the Council of States. Term. The term of office of Vice President is 5 years. It may end earlier either by resignation in writing, address to the President, or by impeachment. The Vice President may be removed by a resolution of the Rajya Sabha passed by a majority of its members and agreed to by the Lok Sabha by a majority. The Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers. The Prime Minister is the head of the majority party or the coalition of parties and the leader of the Lok Sabha. He is also the head of the Union Executive. The president appoints the council of ministers on the advice of the prime minister. The minister in the council must be a member of the parliament. If they are not, they must get elected to the parliament within 6 months of taking office. The council of ministers has three ranks of ministers. The cabinet ministers occupy the highest rank and have independent charges of the most important ministries. Minister of State may assist the cabinet ministers or be holding independent charges of separate ministries. Deputy ministers help cabinet ministers and the ministers of state. Eligibility. To be eligible for the appointment as a minister, a person must be a member of either the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha. A person who is not a member can be appointed for 6 months, but then he or she must obtain membership of any house of the parliament during this time. Usually the prime minister and most of the other ministers are members of the Lok Sabha. Individual and collective responsibility. Each minister is individually responsible for his ministry and department. This responsibility is enforced through the prime minister. The council of ministers is collectively responsible and accountable to the Lok Sabha. The council of ministers will continue in power till they have majority in the Lok Sabha. If the Lok Sabha passes the vote of no confidence, then the entire council of ministers, including the prime minister, has to resign. Even if there is a difference of opinion among the ministers and the prime ministers, they cannot express it publicly. Civil services servants. Besides the union executive, the civil servants play important role in the working of the government departments other than the armed forces. The civil servants perform the day-to-day administrative tasks of the government. In this picture, you can see Cabinet Secretary Rajiv Gauba. The UPSC or the Union Public Service Commission is the special body that recruits the civil servants for the Central Civil Services, which is headed by the Cabinet Secretary. Accountability. India being a democratic country, the people's representatives become ministers and are accountable for each of their actions and decisions. This is one reason why every issue concerning people is discussed, scrutinized and debated in the parliament. If a no confidence motion is passed against even one member of the council, the entire council has to resign and a new election is announced. This is essential for the democratic functioning of the government. During the last 6 decades of democratic rule in the country, many people have been questioning the quality and relevance of the type of the representative democracy in India. But the fact that we are in position to ask questions is itself a clear proof that democracy has been successful and is thriving in our country. Value and life skills. There are many organizations who take care of the education of children who cannot afford to go to school. Do you know of any such organization? Do you really think you can help them in any way? If yes, how? Recapitulation. The President, the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers forms the executive of the central government. The President is the head of the executive at the center level. The President of India has a wide range of administrative, military, diplomatic, legislative, financial and judicial and emergency powers. The Prime Minister heads the Council of Ministers. The Council of Ministers hold collective responsibility to the House of People. The Cabinet Secretary holds the highest post among the civil servants. Thank you, class. Let's meet again in the next chapter.